your whole life.
Spokane, Washington.
Oh.
Is it Spokane?
It is Spokane.
Well, they should get rid of that E.
The E is silent, though. Spokane, Washington.
Spokane.
And?
Louisville. It's not Louisville.
No.
What?
It's Louisville.
Oh, yeah, I've heard that before.
Louisville.
Which is another one of those Joliet things.
Right. Joliet is incorrect. My mom would always say Joliet.
Joliet.
Another one, you know when somebody is not from here when they call it Palatine. Right?
Yeah. There's so many towns around here, too. It's funny when people call it because they change it. Like, Burbank, and some
right.
people are like, it's Burbanus.
Or like, when you say Clarendon Hills.
Clarendon Hills,
you
I
know,
always do.
Clarendon
yes,
Hills.
I'm like, too bad. That's what I say. Tomato, tomato.
All right, we'll put that up on the Star Mobile app on the Facebook page. You can check those out for yourself. How about we take a look at the roads, and here's Dawn Avalo.
355 northbound, stop and go from 88 to St. Charles. 88 eastbound, backs up from Midwest Road to the Eisenhower, and inbound on the Stevenson, heavy from Veterans Parkway to Kedzie. An hour and 15 minutes from 355 to Lakeshore Drive. 80 eastbound, heavy from Hobel to Richards, and westbound from Pulaski to 57, and from 355 to Francis. I'm Dawn Avalo with Star 96.7, Suburban Traffic.
Going to Hollywood.
Last year, Dave Chappelle skipped out on a benefit for Flint, Michigan, after he got a last-minute invitation to go to the Oscars with Chris Rock. But on Wednesday night, he had a gig in Flint, and he made things right when he told the crowd he was donating everything from the show to kids who've been affected by the city's water crisis, and that came to a total of $50,000. As for backing out of last year's charity show, he said, "I'm sorry, everybody. I've never been to the Oscars. You see the movies I make." To see which stars are making a difference, check out our free mobile app for Android and iPhone.
And now, more miles helps you work smarter, not harder. So expected and sometimes so intense. You hear a song and suddenly you are thrown into a vivid memory. Could have a lot of emotion attached to it. Something that you really feel like, oh my gosh, I love this. Or, oh my gosh, does that remind me of a really rough time? Well, what is that power of an older song that triggers vivid memories for us and seems to transport us back in time and space? Well, according to Psychology Today and some new studies, they're finding that listening to music engages broad neural networks in our brains, including the regions responsible for motor actions or our movement, our emotions, and our creativity. A new study has shown that sometimes music can reach through to patients with brain injuries or with Alzheimer's and can still get them to recall something autobiographical. What seems to happen is that a piece of familiar music serves as a soundtrack for a mental movie which starts playing in your head, or even kind of like a tapestry. Star 96.7 with new music.
It's new from Fifth Harmony. Here's All in My Head.